On this episode of Camp Outside, we take a look at campsites 190, 191, 194, 199, and 200 at Fort DeSoto Park near St. Petersburg, Florida. Check it out. Hey guys, I'm Kevin with Camp Outside, your inside source for all things outside. So today we're going to take a look at some of the campsites in Area 3 at Fort DeSoto Park near St. Petersburg, Florida. Fort DeSoto Park is a fantastic park. It's a county park, and it has a great campground. If you haven't ever seen our campground overview video, definitely check that out. I'll put a link down in the description below, as well as our park overview video. Guys, Fort DeSoto is right at the mouth of Tampa Bay on a barrier island. It oversees the Gulf of Mexico as well as Tampa Bay. It's a fantastic place to go swimming, biking, boating. There's a fort there to check out, so it's got some great history. Just a tremendous place to go. So if you haven't been, I highly recommend you plan a trip to Fort DeSoto. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a look at some of the campsites in Area 3 today. Area 3 is suitable for all camping units, whether you're a tent camper or you're rolling in there with a giant RV, but it does not allow pets. So if you want to book a site with pets, you're gonna wanna check out my videos for Area 2. So with that, let's get to the campsite videos. Fort DeSoto Park is located at the mouth of Tampa Bay. It's southwest of St. Petersburg and is easily accessed off I-275. The campground for Fort DeSoto Park is located just south of the boat ramp off the main entrance road. The majority of the campground is on St. Christopher Key, and the entire campground has access to the water and Mullet Key Bayou. The nearest restroom to the sites we're going to take a look at today is restroom number 7. Restroom 7 is a full-service restroom facility with running water, hot showers, flush toilets, and laundry facilities. The first site we're going to take a look at today is site number 190. Site 190 is a back-end site in Area 3 of the campground, which is suitable for all camping units, both tents and RVs, but it does not allow pets. So from the view from the road, you could see that there was trash receptacles just outside this site, making getting rid of your trash easy. There are so many trash receptacles in these campgrounds, there's really no excuse for leaving trash behind. So I hope that the folks who watch these videos are good campers. I'm sure you guys are. So this site is a back-end site on the water. This site is equipped with a picnic table and a charcoal grill. It also has water and electric hookup. It does not have sewer hookup. The site also does not have a fire ring. So if you want a fire for camping at Fort DeSoto, you need to either rent a campfire pit from the camp store for $3 a night or bring a fire ring from home. No ground fires are allowed at Fort DeSoto. The site is plenty big enough for an RV or a camper trailer, or a couple of tents, or a tent and a screen house. The site does open up at the back for access to the water. As you can see from the sign there, swimming is not allowed from the campground at Fort DeSoto. The site does end in a seawall, and people do tie their boats up behind their sites. But you have to be aware of the tide. There's also people who kayak in that little bayou. Site 190 is an excellent site in Area 3. The next site we're going to take a look at is site number 191, which is a pull-through site in Area 3. And the pull-through sites in Area 3 are quite large. They're suitable for any RV or camper trailer, fifth wheel, toy hauler, whatever you're rolling in there with, these sites are big enough for them. They're quite large. So these sites have water and electric hookup on the left, and a picnic table and charcoal grill on the right. These sites offer excellent shade, and they have pretty good privacy to the left and the right with pretty thick vegetation. Just a reminder, there is no sewer hookups in Fort DeSoto, so you do have to go to the dump station in the park to empty out your tanks. But again, I highly recommend these pull-through sites if you need a large or long site for your rig. And that's a look at Site 191. The next site we're going to take a look at is Site 194. And 194 is a back-end site in Area 3. And it's getting out towards the end of Area 3. There's some hot ash receptacle and trash cans along the road there, so you can get rid of your hot ashes or your trash. Again, this site is a back-end site on the water with water and electric hookup on the right, and towards the back of the site, a charcoal grill and a picnic table that you're able to move. They put a lot of sites in the end of Area 3, but they do it pretty well. There's still pretty good vegetation on both sides, offering you some pretty good privacy. It's a little more open than some of the other sites at Fort DeSoto. And of course, the site opens at the back to the seawall. Again, a fantastic place to enjoy the view. As you can see, you can tie your boat up along the seawall if you'd like, and the tides are right. Just a beautiful place to camp. The next site we're going to take a look at is site number 199. And site 199 is a back-end site at the tip of Area 3. Again, Area 3 does not allow pets. As you can see, there's quite a few campsites along this curve. There's a hot ash receptacle. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to shoot all the sites out here. They were occupied the entire time we were in the park. There's some trash receptacles. So if you're looking for a specific number and I've skipped it, it's because it was occupied and I wasn't able to film it. So as we work our way into Site 199, I gotta say, I really like this site. It is not as wide as I would like, but it is still plenty wide for me, and it's pretty deep. Does have water hookup there and electrical hookup just a little farther back, as you can see right there. Again, no sewer hookup at Fort DeSoto. The site is plenty big for tents or screen house, lots of shade, and it's on this point, so it has a charcoal grill and a picnic table and a beautiful view of the water and the mangrove islands in the distance. And again, it's on a seawall. There's no swimming allowed from the campground at Fort DeSoto. But just an excellent, excellent place to enjoy the view. One of the cautions about camping out on the edge like this is that it can be very windy there. So you need to make sure that you guy out your tents and take care of your awnings on your campers and things like that. As you can see, it was a pretty windy day when I shot this. But again, I highly like this site, Site 199. And the last site we're going to take a look at in this video is Site 200. And Site 200 is a back-end site at the tip of Area 3. Again, suitable for all camping units, but does not allow pets. So again, trash cans and hot ash receptacles in this area of the campground. And again, this is another site I really like. Just offers tremendous views of the water. Plenty of shade. And this site kind of opens up a little bit as you get farther into it. Has water and electric hookup. It has a charcoal grill and a picnic table. As you can see, it kind of opens up as you get back further into the site with fantastic views of the water. There's the charcoal grill. Plenty of places to pitch a screen house or a tent, a couple of tents, plenty of room for a camper and RV, lots of palm trees to hang a hammock from, and then just a fantastic view of the water. That's Campsite 200 and the campsites in this video.
So I hope you found those video reviews useful. Couple of things, when you're booking a site at Fort DeSoto, one, always use a desktop computer or a laptop. Do not use the mobile version of the website or an app. That version of the reservation system is terrible. So always use a computer. And guys, you gotta book your sites, especially in the cooler months. You gotta book your sites 6 months ahead of time, 7 months ahead of time if you're a Pinellas County resident. You've gotta get them early. Yes, you can luck into a cancellation, but it's really hard to get a site at Fort DeSoto. The number one question I get asked all the time is, how do I get a site at Fort DeSoto? You have to book in advance. Pick 6 months to the day that you wanna be there. Get on the computer early and pick your site. Also, guys, a couple of things to be aware of when you're coastal camping in Florida. The bugs can be bad, especially the mosquitoes and the no-see-ums. I use a thermocell. I really love thermocells. If you haven't seen my thermocell video, I'll put a link down in the description below. And then, guys, be ready for the weather. So it can be very hot, it can be very sunny, the sun's rays are strong, you definitely want to protect yourself from the sun. And then storms can pop up from offshore and come on shore. You're on a barrier island, so there's really nothing to abate the winds. So if you're on a site that's on the water, it can be very windy. So before you leave for the day, make sure that you guy out your tents or your screen houses or secure your awnings on your RV, put stuff away, make sure nothing's gonna get blown around, because you can be off at the beach for the day and a storm will roll in and just absolutely wreck your campsite. I've seen stuff destroyed by windstorms at Fort DeSoto. So be ready for the bugs, be ready for the wind, but other than that, guys, have a fantastic time at Fort DeSoto. So let me tell you a little bit about Camp Outside if you're new to my channel. So we exist to help moms and dads take their kids camping, hiking, fishing, learn about nature, and develop a conservation ethic. We want to help you get your kids and you outside. So if you have any questions, drop something in the comments below, or you can hit us up at our other social media. We're on Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, and Twitter. All the links are down in the description below, as well as you can check us out on our website at www.kempoutside.com. We release new videos every Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday right here on YouTube at 11 a.m. Eastern Time. And our Monday and Tuesday videos are focused on campground and campsite reviews. And our Thursday videos are on a wide range of topics, from camping, hiking, and fishing to how-to videos, gear reviews, tips and tricks, and a whole lot more. If you want to support Camp Outside, we would love the help. One of the best ways you can do it, guys, is to subscribe, to like this video, comment, and share. That helps me out a ton. But if you also want to support the mission to help parents get their kids outside, whenever you're buying your outdoor gear, guys, use our affiliate links. Our affiliates are down in the description below, or you can get them on our website. But we've got some awesome affiliates, from Amazon and Walmart to Moose Jaw and Toadfish Outfitters, Bass Pro Shops, Cabela's, Roughwear if you've got dogs. We've got a ton of awesome affiliates, so definitely check that out. And guys, it doesn't cost you anything extra when you use our links, but it does give us a little commission on the sale, which definitely helps us to produce these videos. Guys, thanks so much for your support of Camp Outside. Also, guys, I'm gonna put a video right up here and a link down in the description below check out how to win free gear from Kemp Outside. We want to help you get outside, and so we're giving away free gear. Check it out. Make sure you watch that video and get yourself a Kemp Outside sticker. Guys, thanks so much for watching Kemp Outside. We will see you next time.